What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Today, I want to break down a short clip for a recent commercial that we shot for an educational institute down in Irvine. And I want to break down how we did this transition shot to show our main character as he's growing up. In order to pull off this transition, we had to do two shots, one with the younger kid and then the other with the older kid, and then in post, mask them together. The tricky part, though, is that the camera has to move exactly at the same speed, at the same distance, and the characters have to stay in relatively the same area, and the lighting also has to be the same. So a lot of things have to be really consistent in order for us to pull off this transition. If those two shots don't match movement-wise, then it's really, really tricky in post-production. No matter how hard you finesse it, how much you try to stabilize it in post, it's gonna be really hard for you to match those two shots together and make it look clean. So using a gimbal is definitely out of the question, because you'll always get those micro jitters, those up and down movements that you will never be able to get rid of, and it'll ruin the entire effect. So our only option was to use a motorized slider, and this is something you guys have probably heard of before or even used, and they're really great for you to get really precise movement. Now, a company called YC Onion was kind enough to send out their slider for me to test out on our shoot, and it worked out beautifully. Now, with these sliders, you're able to control how fast the camera is moving, whether it pans or not, and then where it starts and ends its movement. It's basically like a little robot that can perform the exact same movements every single time, and that's something that a human can't do. Now, you'll see a lot of people using these for product commercials, time lapses, dolly zooms, etc. There's a lot of ways that you can use a motorized slider. So going back to our transition shot, when you're setting something up like this, you want to make sure that you have something in the middle of your frame that the camera will pass through, and make sure that the camera is passing through the entire object. You don't want to leave any gaps between the top and the bottom of the object. Like, for example, if this water bottle were to pass right through the camera right here, that shot would not work because there's way too much gap between the bottom and the top of this frame. What you want to do instead is have the object pass through like this, so that it covers the entire frame. And this way you can cleanly mask around the object when you're in post. So in my commercial, I place this laptop in the middle of where the camera's gonna be traveling, and I make sure that it's angled and not taking up too much space in the frame. Next, I set my A and B points, which are the start and finish points. Next, I want to have a pretty fast speed because this is a commercial, so the shots are gonna go by pretty quick. And I don't want to have to speed up the footage in post because that would look super unnatural. And lastly, if you want the camera to pan at all around the object, you can adjust that by using these two knobs at the end to control the stick that allows you to pan the camera as it moves. I recommend playing around with the panning, see if that actually adds anything to your shot. Sometimes it makes it look cooler, but if you know that you don't, like me, I didn't want it on my shot at all, so I made sure the stick was straight and not tilted. After you've got all those settings in place, make sure that you lock everything down, because if you touch or change the settings on anything, you have to redo the whole thing again to make sure everything is perfectly matched up. Now, a tip that I have for you is when you're filming, make sure that you run the entire movement all the way from A to B. You don't want to stop the movement halfway because you might be able to use, or you might need to use, that extra little bit of footage at the tail end or at the head when you're editing. In shot number one, make sure that the talent finishes up all of their actions, their performance, before the camera actually pans over the transition object. And then in shot number two, make sure that your talent begins their performance and their actions after the transition object has passed. This way, the transition object doesn't cover up half of the talent's performance. Once you have those two shots in Premiere, you can easily create a mask around the transition object in shot number one. And then you can keyframe the mask so that it follows the transition object until it's completely out of frame. Next, place shot number two underneath shot number one and play around with the timing to get it right. If you've done this correctly, it should be really straightforward and easy to match and time out these two shots together. And the end result should look very seamless. Flaw.
We teach students to grow on their own, building the confidence needed for them to bloom.
So that's it for this video. Hope that helped you guys out. If you want to check out the motorized slider that YC Onion sent me, I'll leave it in the description down below. If you liked this video, please hit that like button, make sure to subscribe, hit the bell to get notified of every video that I post. Until the next one, my name is Alex Chung, and I'll see you later. Bye!